lot of you have been asking on the Cubase YouTubes, how do I create MIDI slices from an audio sample? So in this quick tip video, I'm going to show you just how to do that using the sampler control, which is this tab here. Once you click on it, it loads in the lower zone, or it appears there anyway. I'm going into my MediaBay tab and loops and samples. Now, a lot of this content comes included with Cubase, and when I click on it, I can instantly hear it played in the tempo of my project, which is neat because I don't need to do any time stretching. So I'm just selecting different samples, and when I find one I like, I drag and drop it right over into this area here. I could also drag it up into the project, but we're going to slice it, so I'm going to use the sampler control to do that. Once you've dragged your sample in, you can trigger it with a MIDI controller, and the lower you play, the lower and slower the sample is going to play, and of course the higher, well, it's going to be opposite. But what we really want to do is slice this up into different components, so capture every small component of the loop. So you do that in the slice tab, and you can trigger these different components using your mouse. You can also change the way that Cubase detects all of the hit points using this encoder right here. So if you move it to the left, you'll have less, to the right more. Pick up on this MIDI icon and drag it up onto the sampler track in the project area, and now you're perfectly triggering that sample basically with a MIDI event. So all of these little blocks are basically triggering all of the little sections that we had down in our sampler control section, which is really cool for a number of reasons. If we go down to the sampler control, you can see that these little areas here are basically sequentially being triggered. But what if we don't want to trigger them in order? What if we want to change the actual order of the drum sample itself? Well, then you can pick up on one of the components that you don't want, and you can change it and drag it around to another instrument. That's really cool because it means we can completely mess with a sample. So I've added an extra snare and an extra kick. Now, another question on the YouTubes was, how do I create ghost notes with drums? Well, basically you copy and paste them and then you alter the velocity and you decrease the velocity. So have a listen to this. So straight away we've added some ghost notes for extra effect, and that's pretty cool. So you can be as creative as you want using these components that we've sliced up into MIDI events. They're still audio events down in the sampler track, but we're triggering them with these MIDI events. And there's so many different things you can do. For example, you could make a fill or a sweep. Now, you can also highlight the different MIDI events and change the velocity, which means we're altering the volume of the sample. And of course, there's so many flexible ways that you can actually work with velocity in the key editor. So basically, we're manipulating audio using the key editor and MIDI. Thanks for taking the time to stop by and check this video out. Give us a thumbs up and subscribe to the Cubase YouTube channel. See you there.